Need to find a way forward. Seems like a good moment to talk.
You smell very delicious, but I will not
Hope you're keeping well, friend.
No time to dally.
Touch.
What to do? These boots have seen everything. There's a trap. Always room for more. Something good here, I hope.
Tim asks, known to cause confusion. Best not get too close.
Give up now. No one stopped me yet. Should mind my step.
Timask. The spores confuse the senses.
Timask and torch
spores. Not sure what the other mushrooms are.
Hell of a combination. Get confused by one, blown up by the other.
Never wanted the easy path. I'll take that.
Corpses. These creatures did battle with Dwergar.
The corpse has nothing to say.
Hope you're keeping well, friend.
You are swallowed by a chorus of turbulent music. Through one creature sing many voices. The harmony of an entire collective.
Sovereign, she has come. She is here.
The choir fades. A single melody rises above the others, brassy and commanding.
I am sovereign.
You see a vision. Your lifeless body wrapped in fungal tendrils. The Sovereign is threatening you.
State your purpose.
You detect a distinct quiver in every note. These creatures have experienced recent tragedy. Fungal roots weave through your mind, seeking your true intent. Then the Sovereign drones a new melody, cautious but welcoming.
Descend to me. Let us speak in flesh.
The persistent music coaxes you forward. The Sovereign expects you. Fungus and mold glaze the grotesque creature. A voice drifts into your mind as you get...
Leave the... Seek.
Inside.
Perhaps Amelium is right. I should
seek. Fleshwalker, tongue talker, far you've come, reach into memory, tell me of home.
It reveals its own home in reply. A humid cove filled with decaying myconid corpses.
Dwegar destroyed my people. I am a sovereign with no circle. I do not belong here. I am not welcomed here.
What could they accomplish?
What is the creature doing to those corpses?
Sovereign's thick fingers stroke the corpse at its feet. A droning melody greets you as the creature turns its gaze to you.
flesh talker. I show you a memory. Watch and listen.
A violent vision grips you. Dwega, dark dwarves chopping Myconid remains.
They broke our peace. They killed our young.
The Sovereign's song slows to the pace of a dirge. It is still in mourning.
We laid waste to many, but intruders remain. Lakewood.
The Sovereign's song halts as it measures your worth.
I sense your resolve. You will find Dwega invaders near Lake's Edge. Cleanse the rot. Destroy them.
Dwegar invaders? We can manage that. Better than picking this fight, surely.
The Sovereign's song twists into images. Dwega changing size, slipping in and out of invisibility, invoking craven divinity. An illusion comes over you. A Dwega choking on a cloud of gleaming dust.
Accept this gift. It will help you exterminate.
The Sovereign gifts you one more vision. A wall of vines parting to reveal glowing light.
Riches of magic and mind. Cleanse the rot, and they are yours. You do the Circle a service. We will await word. We breathe life into our enemies' flesh. The dead make a fine host for my growing children.
If I die down here, destroy my corpse.
Don't worry. I wouldn't hesitate.
You may not. The spores hear only the Circle. They dance to no other harmony.
The Sovereign says nothing, but you hear appreciation in its song. It greets you with a harrowing elegy, cheerless as the new moon.
We breathe life into our enemies' flesh. The dead make a fine host for my group.
If I die down here...
Don't worry. I wouldn't hesitate.
What more would you ask?
Dwega faces appear before you one by one.
Ah, a visitor. You're a welcome sight. But let us observe the customs of the locals.
The scholar's brow tenses. His voice spills into your skull. The spores connecting mind to mind.
Blurg, proud member of the Society of Brilliance, at your service. Or perhaps not. Your mind is far more complex than that of the fungi. Understandable. We are small in number and rarely stay in one place for long. My colleagues and I are working to improve conditions in the Underdark. This need not be such a dire, hostile place. It's curious to find a surface dweller here. What has brought you down so deep? Truly remarkable. But why come to the Underdark, where they hold so much power? You were infected by an illithid tadpole? It's a miracle you're still intact. You must be worried sick, but have no fear. I have a friend who may be able to assist. Omelium!
I hope this is important, Blurg. My Zirkwood samples need constant attention.
It is. This adventurer has an illithid tadpole inside her head, but she hasn't turned.
No seromorphosis? That's impossible, but intriguing. Are you looking to have it extracted?
Geich, your head will make a fine trophy for my queen.
Please hold. I understand your rage against my kin. One of my brethren forced a tadpole into your eye. Or ear, perhaps? But I assure you, I stand with the Society of Brilliance, not the colonies of my people.
Fool! They infest your head and invade your dreams, and still you would parley!
I ask only that you refrain from violence. I respect that your opinion of my kind may be charged. If that settles matters for the time being, would you like a diagnosis? Open your mind to me. Let us see what lurks within.
As the Meloan's mind pierces yours, the tadpole pulses with power. It feels 10 times its size, alive, awake, almost smug.
This is most unusual. The incubation period should be complete, as should your transformation. But the larva is infused with strange magic. It appears to be in some form of stasis. I can only theorize, but I suspect your transformation would be both agonizing and instantaneous.
I thought it was always agonizing, Omelium.
Well, yes, but that wasn't my point. No. It appears to be shielded from physical and magical influence. And even without the shield, the extraction would involve severe cranial trauma. It is not ideal. The process would surely kill you. But not to worry. Should you transform, I will happily perform a new examination. A Nautiloid? Fascinating. I have never set foot on one myself. They were our warships during the greatest eras of the Illithid Empire. We ruled the entire astral plane from their decks. The design was lost when the Gith rebelled and ended our dominion. Of course. I am sorry I cannot assist you in its removal. But I have an idea.
Oh, perhaps I should start taking notes.
There may be a way to bypass that stasis. There are many alchemical substances that can influence the mind. I do not intend to shatter its protection, I need only bypass the interference that prevents me from communicating with the lava. A tincture distilled from a collection of rare mushrooms. They have subtle psionic influence. I would require a fresh tongue of madness and Timusk spores. But be warned, in their natural state, both of these mushrooms can be quite dangerous. Timusks cause confusion in those that approach them. The tongue is self-explanatory.
The Underdark, of course, although they are quite rare, and their discovery perilous. I imagine Lenore would have them in her possession. She served Mistra as a cleric. She is quite fond of her garden. Lenore has always been a lonely sort. Nature was her only companion. I offered her the chance to join the society, but she refused. Her experiments on Sousa bark took priority.
My formula will hamper the more harmful effects once the mushrooms are brewed into a potion. Your sanity, however much you possess, should remain intact. May your travels be safe and swift. I have never seen anything like it.
One day I'll catch a break. Anything of use?
How is your morgue?
What's up for discussion?
I greet you, child of the sun. At the moment it's so I left his company. Perhaps the peoples of the Underdark will be less in- You must drink the entire drop.
Omeluan watches you with cautious intensity. It expects doubt.
But unless you are already-
The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. A few sparks and colors dance around Omeluun, but you stay steady and staring ahead. The tadpole spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. Cold blades lose their edge. You are stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluun, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. Such an outcome was not in my calculations. There is more to this being than mere stasis. Such crude destruction may not waylay a lava like this, but there is another possibility. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn?
As Omeluun watches your performance, something stirs in his mind, unusual for an illithid. Joy.
Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me.
That thing better work. If it doesn't, I doubt you'll be in any position to complain.
Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth.
Have you spoken with Skriss lately?
Yes. She is cataloging Kuotuan fertility rituals. I greet you, Sunchild. May your travels be...
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? The feeling is mutual, friend. I have only passing familiarity with the surface races. But I found that there is as much to learn from an individual as there is from a community. So it is with the Myconids. They live in harmonious unity. But each has a unique personality. Yes, but it has abundant natural resources. Spores, water orbs, Trillimac. I've studied them for years.
There is rare magic in the Underdark too. Fersres. It radiates from the earth, warping, teleportation, and divination magic.
This is not a wasteland. It is a glorious ecosystem. Every civilization here could thrive without conflict. I observe the fight from a distance. Combat is not my field of expertise, but the Myconids handle themselves well enough. I do enjoy a good bargain. If anything in my private collection is to your liking. very well.
How far can I go? But that will fit in my pack. Have to keep going.
Want Master back. He treats me good now. Doesn't kick me anymore.
Very well.
Seems the shrooms are letting in more people every day. You see a fella on his own on your way in. Dwarf. Balin's his name. Bald, blue tunic, dumb as a stick. Right, never mind. My useless husband. Sent him for an errand. It's no surprise he's made a mess of it. Knock yourself out. But don't come begging for coin if you find him. You try to ransom him to me, you'll find yourself skint and stuck with a fat old lout. Might be enough to cover rent.
Monstrosity stare.
That's just a little stench in exchange for a lot of power. Thank you.
Warden Frost. I must heal.
I'm ready.
All's well that ends not as bad as it could have. Moving in. Corpse twitches in response to the spell, and you note its delicate filaments. It had been merely a child. Like its living counterparts, the corpse speaks in your mind.
To grow, to know, to be one with the circle. Greed wars, hurt a sprout. Noom, death. Noom, death. Floating, knowing, seeing.
The spell's power. With haste.
Don't.
Her condition is familiar. Poison, derived from a wild weed common to the Underdark. She'll need an antidote soon, most likely held by the poisoner.
Slashed me. Myconids. Oh, took pity on me. Sound lads, especially since the Greys gave them ill for it.
These Myconids are the welcoming sort, at least where blubbering gnomes are concerned.
Like dwarves, Duergar have innate resistance to poison, and thus no need for intricate brews. Though deadly, if left untreated, the poison can be cured by the antidote or natural remedies.
Not going. That is, I needed it. Why are you helping me? No arguments there. Felt like a hook horror was sorting through my guts. But that cure did the trick. Quick, sharp too. I thank you for your help, but I gotta get moving. Oh, it hurts. Girl's garters. Oh. I don't have time for this. My kin need me. Seems you're the helping kind. All right. I need you to rescue my kin. Not charity, mind. We can pay. We're Ironhand Clan. Best artificers in Baldur's Gate.
We were on an expedition down here when the Dwergar snatched us up. I got away, but not the others. The Greys have them digging out some old ruin across the lake. Just mining for materials. Nothing unusual.
The briefest hesitation, but enough. She's lying.
But our work pays well. Help my clan, and we'll make it worth your while. I swear. Fine. It's complicated. But my clan has trouble back in the city. A blood feud. We were searching for something to turn the tide. That's all I can say. But it's worth a lot to us. Understand? Look, you've done me a good turn and you deserve the truth. But that's as much of it as I can tell. I swear it. If you need to go your own way, I respect that, but still, I'm asking. Thank you. Only wish I could go with you. But here. I nabbed these boots from the Greys when I ran. I'll feel better knowing you're using them to kick some Dwergar ass. I'll mark where I made my escape, and wait here, I suppose. Not much choice, eh?
How is your maul?
I want to have a word.
Go.
Wish I had a bag of holding. To put my hands on everything.
camp. Looks abandoned. What's in here? With your keen eyesight, the hole below you soon plummets into an abyss of impossible darkness. Your call echoes as it plunges downward, before gradually fading away. Even with your keen eyesight, deep.
These things drain away one's
still fresh.
Magic.
Shouldn't some monster did this, marking its territory.
Cloak and dagger, my favorite.
Sometimes the only way out is through.
Thank you.
still breathing, despite everything. The gods are watching me. Blood follows me everywhere.
My faith will protect me. Victory awaits.
Don't mind if I do.
Minster's not around, so it might as well. For a dull moment. Swift as my feet can carry me. Mm-hmm.
Stop! Stop!
Bibberbang!
Where Bibberbang blows, Noblestalk grows. The dwarf was harvesting valuable Noblestalk amongst these explosive Bibberbang mushrooms.
I got it yet! Got stuck here instead!
Scroll! Escape! My bag, please! I've dropped it somewhere! Thank you. Thank.
No rest for the wicked, I see.
Of course.
What are you doing? Get out of there! Stop! Stop, Bibber!
You recognize the name. Bibberbang, a mushroom.
Scroll! Escape! My bag!
Hi.
Bone cloak. Did it. My bag. Please.
Yes! That's it!
God. I can finally breathe. Right, as, what were you saying? I was looking for Dereth. She'll be worried sick. I must need to go. For you. Your trouble.
Moving ahead.
The air is ripe with magic.
All right, what now? What path lies before me? Going. On my way.
Witch Queen shan't take me my joy.
My patience wanes. Not one false move. I'm ready.
Don't want to think about why my eye is itching. Never wanted the easy path. Fury. Come on, can't stay idle. You picked the wrong fight, friend.
Taken its toll. I should rest.
Whatever comes, I'm ready. Off I go. Focus. Strike true. No choice but to keep going. One day, I'll catch a break.
That's the plan. Time to strike. Got to keep fighting.
on the move.
What fools these mortals be.
The corpse regards you lifelessly.
Zero. Forgotten. Forsaken. My pack found me, fed me.
Zargrim, Three Seek, Adamantine Forge. Only one of us may find.
The spell's power went.
I had a bag of holes.
I've got the plans and the Sousa bark. Now I need somewhere to craft it all. Crystal shine. Rock under your feet juts upwards, forming a perfectly engraved tombstone with a small epitaph. In memory of Myrna, a shining light in this dark world, may you forever gaze upon the lake you love to play in. As you dig, you slowly expose the skeletal remains of a large dog wearing a chunky leather collar.
Strange collar. It's got runes all over it. This must have belonged to Lenore's dog. Definitely magical, too. Have a look.
The mushroom?
I knew I was forgetting something.
What?
Sorry, love.
Absolutely worthless.
70 years of terror. For what?
Dink, Balin, dink. My friend, Bibberban. Curious. Beautiful. But dangerous. Next time. More careful next time. For certain. Thank you for your help. What were you saying? Noble stock. Yes. Derek needs noble stock. Mushroom. Good stuff. And the ledge. Yes. I was on a ledge. Crumbled to bits. And I tumbled down. The shop needs all we find. Bone cloaks. Baldur's Gate. Anything sourced here. Very high rate of profit. Mushroom. Powerful. Dirith wants it for a brew. She's very good, my Dirith. Very good at a brew. My words get away from me. You'll have to ask Dirith. She knows the ins and outs.
Look at that. Got my useless old man back. I suppose that's your doing. His hands are empty as a whole. We'll have to send him back out soon enough. Please, Balin's got a job to do. We can leave when he's done it. Love? Never heard of it. Balin's meek now, but he used to be a rotten old bastard. Treated me like an old shoe for 70 years. Losing his mind was the only good he ever did by me. Collecting noble stock. Valuable mushroom. We've a shop in Boulder's Gate. The locals go mad for it. Nearly nothing it can't cure. Blindness, poison, hair loss. Probably. But Balin in his right mind wasn't worth half a half of noble stock. I know him better than anyone. Got the scars to prove it. Of terror. For what? Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood. An efficient path.
Can't be too careful in these parts. Paper bangs the least of it. Did you take that? Did it once it very badly. Very, very badly indeed. Oh, very glad.
At the ready. We'll be clearing out soon enough. You come across a noble stock mushroom about, you give it here. Gods know I've earned it. Ah, to no surprise of mine, you're more competent than Balin. Go on then, hand it over. Sell it, what else? Worth more than its weight in gold to folk back in Baldur's Gate. There ain't much it can't cure. Thanking you. I'll be on my way then. Look. I do thank you. Come visit me in Baldur's Gate if you find yourself that way. I run a shop called Bone Cloaks. Balin nearly sunk the shop to pay for a drink, when he was of his own mind. This might allow me to hang on a little longer. You take care out here.
Indolence breeds madness. Objective noted. Something's on my mind.
Can't be too careful in these parts. Paper bangs the least of it.
Here we go. Swift as my feet can carry me.
Please protect me.
ready and willing.
Assume nothing. If not over, then through. Inside. Prime spot for an ambush. Watching me. Better be cautious. Can't risk being in open view. Never wanted the easy bomb.
What? Gek! Got someone sneaking up on us!
What's this? Got ourselves an infiltrator? You move pretty quietly. Not quietly enough for my liking, though. Noise gets you eaten down here. Reckon I'll hush you before something hungry comes along.
His gnarled fist grips an axe.
Fine. I'll let you live. But spoil my hunt, and you're dead. Share? You really are in the wrong place, son scum. Try this for useful. Falling down a deep, dark hole is the kindest death you'll find in the Underdark. Told you, hunting. Slave ran away, took Sergeant Thryn's boots.
Gotta kill the slave and fetch back the leather. Or the bosses in Moonrise will have Thryn's hide.
Sergeant told me to. Besides, we're talking about a slave. A bleeding heart, are you? Reckon I'll just roast and eat it.
My patience wanes. Unheard, unseen. Cloak and dagger, my favorite.
Thank you.
Nothing will stand in my way. Another fight. Let's go.
Way.
Concentrate.
Get too close.
time to strike.
This is worth the cost.
Can't afford to let up.
I don't fancy their chances.
Done.
Can't even catch my breath.
Mistress is wrong.
Gone with the weave.
Certainly.
Death.
awaits. My path be true.
Still breathing, despite everything. Cutting to the chase. Need to find a way forward.
Up. Pushing on.
Time to press ahead. Better not be cursed. Open up. good here, I hope. What creatures live in waters this dark? Something over there. What's that? Flackets will be done. At least that stayed interesting. Should mind my step. Seems simple enough. I need a quick word.
It greets you with a harrowing elegy, cheerless as the new moon. The music shifts, still melancholic, but now streaked with hope.
Do you hear a new harmony? Serenity. I name you Peace Bringer.
Fragrant spores waft through the air. Your heart swells with bliss with your every breath.
Freely you have given to us. Freely you may take. The Guardian Gate is open. Go and claim your reward. But before this, I have another boon to ask of you. You have cut out the Dwergar Blight, but not its source.
In your mind's eye, Spore shows you a drow, striding among Myconid dead.
Nir, this one is called. He hunted us. Hunt him in turn. Bring me his head, and I will know my circle is safe. The drow lurks in the ruins beyond the lake. Bring him death, and return.
I'm coming along, just not fast enough.
I'm almost sorry to hear it.
I hope to have the pleasure myself. There's plenty more guarding my people, but I'd say you've made a fine start. Don't know. Longer than I'd like, but a slow recovery still recover.
Corpse regards you lifelessly.
Zargrim, conjurer, seeker, battle with rival, summoned spectator. The adamantine forge. Filro, Dorn, each held knowledge none would share. Secret to its operation book disguised by magic.
The spell's power wanes. You can ask no more questions.
Again with the adamantine forge. These people need a new hobby.
The cover proudly announces this book to be Flumph Mating Rituals. If the drow's corpse is to be believed, it's something else entirely. The scrutiny proves too much. The lurid text melts away before your eyes. An illusion. What remains are simple instructions written in a spare hand. The secret to forging adamantine.
watch them next time.
You smell very delicious, but I will not bite.
Soldier?
Hello, my dear.
You know, I've been catching myself smiling.
Shouldn't have made me your enemy.
Speak.
You wish to speak? Well met. How can I help?
What's hiding here?